Greetings, everyone. This is First and 2073 with the next episode of Geopolitical Simulator 4, Power and Revolution, Return to the Golden Age of Greece. The last two episodes, we attempted to expand our military power, building an airbase on the island of Rhodes, increasing our army career enlisted soldiers a thousand by increasing them by 1,000 troops. And we've also, commando numbers are going up, that's good. And we also tried an arms deal with France, which gave us 24 more new advanced tanks, 12 new advanced rocket launchers, and 15 new highly advanced helicopters. Those are on their way, being delivered. However, there were some bad domestic reactions, and the pacifist union, which has been hitting us pretty hard. Where's that pacifist union? With the protests and rioting, which actually got violent. Doesn't make any sense, pacifist union getting violent. Can't click on them for some reason. What's going on here? I don't know what's going on with that. I hope this game's not going to crash. Knock on wood. Okay, so we're going to try to revive our domestic opinion by increasing our energy production. Looked at the energy consumption in the last episode, and we are at 51 terawatts, only producing 49 terawatts. We went over our capacity there. So, if we look at what we have, what are we producing? Fossil fuel, hydroelectric, 2 onshore wind platforms. And that's it. Oh, we have some biomass too. I don't really know what that is exactly. I'm going to go ahead and I looked at the onshore wind platforms. Oh, the other thing is, too, just real quick, unemployment. Whoa, unemployment has gone up to almost 4%. All right, so it's time to start employing people. So one thing we're going to do is we're going to exonerate a number of industries around steel and electrical components, but that's going to be second. I don't know if I'll get to that this episode or not. But in this episode, we're definitely going to first look at energy production. And onshore wind platforms will cost an annual reimbursement of $310,000, where offshore wind platforms are $369,000. So we're going to try to get, and they do employ more people. We do have a pretty big availability of manpower here, over almost 100,000. We got some people working on that airbase and roads. I'm going to go ahead and build, I think, 10. Wind farms. If you look at the wind farm, you get 0.92. It seems like they produce the most. 0.92 wind farms. That means that you're going to have about 0.46 per wind farm. So if I build 10, that'll get us back up to like 53 terawatts. I might also experiment with geothermal and solar just to build one of each, just to see exactly how much. This is $1 million. Annual reimbursement. This is pretty cheap. And then this one's 21. Solar is expensive. $21 million reimbursement. So if I build 10 of those wind platforms, that's going to roughly give us about $3 to $4 million in expenses. And then geothermal will put us about at $5 million annual reimbursement for the next 5 years. And then solar will be 21, so that's going to be like $26-27 million added to the budget. And we've got money to spend. Like I said before, we are now down. Public debt is now down below $300 billion, which we should get some popularity increase for that. But 27-30 million dollars is not even going to put a dent into this budget excess. So let's go ahead and start construction on a number of these things. Maybe it'll increase our popularity. Here we go. That's environment again. I did it again. All right. Energy. Onshore wind platforms. Position. This island right here has pretty good positioning for the wind platforms and doesn't look too habitable. So we're going to go ahead and try to get as many of them as possible here. That's one. And that's kind of close to Athens, too. So I don't know if that matters at all, like how close the energy... It should, but I don't know if the game computes that at all. How close energy production is to the areas where the energy is being consumed. There we go. Good production capacity right there. Oh, look at that. No, that was just a shadow. I thought that gave us access. No. All right, so we're going to build wind farms throughout this entire island here, basically. That looks like it's farming. I can't tell. Doesn't look like there's really any development going on these islands. That's two. All right, we're going to get eight more. Energy. And if we can't fit them here, we can put them in that street, because they're actually... Is it's not gonna tell. Yeah, good production capacity there. Can I fit one in here? No. Right there. Analyzing. Good protection capacity. Oh, come on. Alright, it's not letting me click. What the heck was that? That's two. I'm hoping this doesn't crash the game. Ah! Running out of room. There we go. Alright, we got four. I don't know if we're gonna get them all on the island. But we can put them in this, in these straits and in that bay if we need to. Wish I could do, like, more at once. Okay, here we go. Nice. Nice and close together there. Good production capacity there. That's six. Four more to go. Too close. There we go. That's seven. Not a lot of space for these things. Eight. Nine. Then we'll see if we can fit the last one on the island. That'll keep our expenses down. 3.1 million. Over 5 years. Come on, baby, get me there. No. Good production capacity. Trying to squeeze this guy in. Ah! Can't get him. No, it doesn't look good. Alright, let's see if we can put it on the island over here. That's good production capacity. Good. Alright. So we got all onshore wind farms that are just going to take up the entire islands, these entire islands here. Let's go ahead and press play, see if that gave us any type of bonus, hopefully. Clean energy, job producing, come on. How long is this going to take these guys? These will be constructed in 180 days. 180 days with 270 days with those air bases. And any type of reaction. Whoa, what is that resolution on the Portugal? What is this? The Portuguese resolution, or the Latvian initiative, went ahead. And military intervention mandate. Resolution has been accepted. 15 people have voted in favor. Even the Russians are in favor of the intervention, but I think the conflict is over.
One of my men succeeded in infiltrating key center.
Good.
One of my men succeeded in infiltrating.
Good, we're infiltrating both groups. Happiness has increased in Greece, but my popularity has not risen. Now, everybody ruled for intervention against Belarus, but I don't see anybody actually intervening. Where's my growth? Growth in my economy is up to almost 10%. Inflation is at 6.89. I'm nervous about doing those steps that I said as far as... I said that I wanted to exonerate certain industries around steel and electrical components, but with that high inflation and that growth, that makes me kind of nervous. The other step is to pull out of the Eurozone and control the inflation ourselves. So that's an option. Population growth. Where's our population? Population growth. Population is definitely growing. I think a lot of that has to do with immigration. Immigration rate. Yes, the immigration rate has grown. Let's go under immigration. We're up to 32,000 people, which has grown about 7,000, but it looks like it leveled off. So, illegal immigrants are coming in too. I'm going to sit tight for a little bit and see what happens. Let's run through August. Statement in the press. Hit us. Who hit us in the press? Alright, Central Alternative Party. Pleased with the biting wit with the Prime Minister has faced problems. That's a good thing in the press. Oh, okay, here we go. Seriously, are there people who dare to say in public they voted for me? Yeah, I knew it. Who's this guy? Who's this guy? Satirical humorist. Yeah, that guy's been hurting us, huh? Turkey wants to meet. Alright, we might as well meet with them. Oh. Oh man, here it is. We now have confidential information that the Turkish government has secretly financed total jihad terrorists which attack Algeria. I've already communicated this information with your secret services. Now we can bring a UN resolution against Turkey, but Turkey is way too powerful for us to take on, and I can't expand my military. Because every time I do, the pacifist union goes crazy. Oh boy, we're going to file that away for now. And just wait to see what happens. And I'm going to wait to see what people suggest on the channel. there's a lot of things I wanted to do in the series, and if I declare war on Turkey, it could end the series very quickly. As far as head of state is concerned, especially with our popularity being so low, we are not in the best situation. Elections are in 1,148 days. Cancel that. When is the actual date of the election? October 3rd, 2021. So we've got about 3 more years in office till we have to run for re-election. My popularity is very low. What is the budget looking like? Our budget excess is still above $14 billion. So we've got money. Ah! Let's speed this up. Okay, so. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Something's happened here. Anti-terrorism. Care for refugees.
As I predicted, the systematic analysis of the habits of small groups has allowed
43%, which is basically two people. We can now state, when are you going to eliminate these groups? Analysis, total jihad. I don't want to approach total jihad. I want to approach the Turkish, the Kurdish Renaissance, but I'm avoiding approaching total jihad. So, should we bring forward that information against Turkey? I am not ready to confront Turkey, that is for sure.
You have to strike while the
iron. Alright, they're telling me to get more active.
I have to tell you that I am filled with pride to be the mother of a leader who is so loved by.
Okay, 71% like me.
The theory that says if E1 doesn't like E2.
Yeah, I do want to approach the Russians. change the date to Saturday. Approach the Russian Worker Party, and that, we can fund them. Maybe we can get Putin out of office. Russia. Oh, Putin is out of office. But they are still conservative rightist. Who is this person? Get off of my alignment with head of state. That looks pretty good. Strategic alignment's negative, but economic relationships is pretty good. Maybe we can buy something from them, improve the economic relations with the Russians. There is a scandal here. I could reveal the scandal. Next elections are in... I could reveal the scandal. Right around the time of the election. Which would interfere in the Russian elections. That sounds like a pretty interesting turn of the tables there. Putin's out, but I think it's still a conservative party there. We want a more liberal party. We want that Russian Workers' Party on our side, and maybe that can get the strategic alignments and increase our improve our relations with the Russians. To keep them out of Serbia, if we decide to intervene in Serbia when that happens. If and when that happens. Alright, the Turks want to sell us fuel. Let's see what we got here. Oh no, cancel. I don't want that. They want to buy fuel from us. They want to buy fuel from us. Are we selling fuel? Are we selling fuel or are we buying fuel? I thought we were buying fuel. I feel like I don't have... I feel like this is a no. I'm gonna refuse this. But... Ooh, what was that option? Threaten to reveal scandals involving him. Now we're getting pretty, what would that do? Does that mean I could get them to do what I want them to do? I don't know what that means exactly. But it looks interesting. Now, I'm going to look at certain industries where I want to buy stuff. Let's see here. We got chemical. We need a copper. They don't have any copper. What else did I need? Found it. Copper, gold, electricity. We're gonna start producing rare earth oxides. Gold. They have gold. Do they have gold? They are not. They're consuming more gold than they're producing. Turkey is becoming one of these modern industrialized states that just is consuming more resources than they're producing, which will lead to less trade relations with them. No rare earth oxides. Iron. Come on, there's got to be iron in Turkey. There's tons of mountains. No, wow. All right, Turkey's kind of worthless at this point. They're more of a consuming economy, I guess, so there's going to be something we're going to try to sell to. But I'm not making any sales right now. Because my economy is growing way too high. I threatened to reveal scandals involving him. I'm going to wait on that one. We're ending that for now. Let me know what you guys think. Should I threaten the Turkish Prime Minister to reveal the scandals against them or not? And the other thing is, when the person gets removed from office, does that mean we no longer have the dirt on them? It doesn't really equate because it's a different administration. Which, if that is the case, then we probably should... Oh, we got time for this guy. Lebanon's my ideal target right now, I think. And when this airbase gets constructed in 230 days, we're going to move an air wing into position And I think we'll be able to launch strikes to take out airfields. Lebanese airfields. There we go. Financial aid.
I'm listening carefully.
Boom.
Thank you for your precious support. I can assure you that the government is getting ready to live its last hours.
Sounds good. Get rid of that guy. Get rid of that conservative government. Political party is a conservative rightist party. We want that removed from office. Our GDP is looking pretty good. $234 billion. Warmongering has got me.
The funeral will take place next
God.
Do you want to attend?
Warmongering now has me below 70%. It might be time to pass a law or something. A popular law, or maybe a popular tax. What the heck? Are there any taxes that are popular? Inflation is climbing again. Available position. Yeah, go ahead and fill it. I'm not going to deal with that right now. Inheritance tax? ...74% like it. People seem to like it. I'm gonna do this and see if I can improve anyone's funeral. Alright, good. We got a nice little bump from the funeral. I don't know what reform to call this. This will be estate reform. Alright, let's see if we can't improve our popularity with some popular taxes. What about the tax on pornography? Is that popular? Not as popular. Oh, good lord! That just killed us. Okay, maybe we attach employee social security payments to that. And that's gonna hurt our budget. This is not happening the way we wanted it to. That will pass and people will love it. Alright, we're gonna do that. Attach that to the estate bill. Quick bump, 4%. Eliminate Lebanon. No, I don't want to do that. Definitely not.
Business leaders are currently.
Your modern vision of feminism has moved the cause of women forward.
I need some popularity.
Your modern.
I might have to do some other major tax cuts just to get my popularity back up. See what happens once I pass the bill. Funeral appearance. Who's this guy? Is that the new guy that they appointed? Into the cabinet. This guy constantly. This guy's the worst. Look at this. 47 popularity. And for some reason, I can't click on him. I'm gonna probably end this episode soon because I've been playing this game for a while and I think it might be draining it a little bit. I hope it's not gonna crash again. There's certain things. Damn, what is that? Statements in the press. I think that's probably the humorist. So, I could start investigating local people like the humorist. And some other organizations. I'd say my enemy list would be the Pacifist Union. And they're the biggest ones. The Pacifist Union and the humorist, the satirical humorist, seem to be my biggest enemies, and they seem to be knocking my popularity down. Here we go.
Huh, that's. Thanks. It's very kind. Okay, if it.
And that's good. Oh, I should have asked her if she wanted to accept the ministry. Minister position. Which ones do I need? Why can't I click on these guys? It's a game. Alright, so justice and employment seem to be the two areas. Two ministers and defense. Justice, employment, and defense do not seem to be very popular. Now, justice minister. He loves me. Alright, we're going to keep him. Defense. He loves me. We're going to keep him. And then employment. And these are strategies based on recommendations from Hugo Batista from a couple episodes ago. This guy's borderline, but I'm not... doesn't hate me. So my cabinet looks okay.
Undoubtedly, you will remain the face of the combat.
Nice statement in the press from the women's leaders.
Undeniably, you have inside you the founding.
We're going to set up a meeting with her, but I'm going to change the date for next month to see. Actually, let's go into November. We'll go into November. We'll try to set up a meeting with her November 5th. See if I can get a good endorsement from her in 2 months and try to hopefully bring this popularity up a little bit more. That law will be passed and certain people are going to like it because of the benefits it gives to reducing the expenses of Social Security payments, which is going to cost us a sizable amount, but we're getting backed up a little bit by the inheritance tax. So employee Social Security, I think that was down 240 something. This is 20 something, so it'll be a little over $200 million taken off of the budget excess. But the budget excess is growing, continues to grow. Press play as we pay down our debt. So it looks like we're good. Like I just looked at that like a month ago, I think, and it was like at 14, like 17, and we've grown. And so, but we still have a problem with inflation that's rising, and unemployment, and our growth is really high. Okay, so I'm not gonna hit the inheritance tax anymore. Please, hopefully, I remember to do that, to not do that again. But if I cut taxes, that's going to help the economy grow even more, which is going to drive up inflation even more. It might be time to leave the Eurozone. That might be what we're looking at here. The European Union seemed pretty weak in reacting to that Belarusian intervention. NATO has definitely failed up there. Whoa, there we go.
The vote was held and the reforms adopted.
Nice. 14-point bump back into the 80s. And let's get this guy. Let's get a meeting with this guy. We'll set him up for December, I think. Set up a meeting with him. This might be too far in advance. We'll set up a meeting with him in December. Done. Beneficial popularity. Undoubtedly, your popularity is measured by actions of the government. Very good. And I think we're looking good. Kosovo Network, eliminate head of state. Ah, I don't know about that one. Huh. No, I don't think so. If you do eliminate the head of state, that could change the alignment, maybe. I don't know. I've never done that before. I'm still waiting for that. Committed filmmaker. How's a difficult time for the citizens? Unemployment's dropping now. The economy is growing. I'm not gonna do that. At a fantastic rate here. I'm gonna try to push to the end of the quarter here for this episode and get through some time and see what those end of the quarter results are. Let's take a look at the taxes. Our budget excess is $14.54 billion. Even with the reduction of payments, warmongering is killing me. can't get out of that conflict. Whoa, Montenegro. Okay. No, 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 no. They want to kill everyone. They want to. My guys want to kill every head of state out there. Alright, we've gone into October. There's our surplus.
Good news. Our financial performance in the last quarter shows a cash surplus. This will help us reduce our debt service.
We should get a bump in public finance. 29. There we go. $294 billion. I should be seeing a reaction here. And that will be the end of the episode, I think. After I get these results. There we are. Whoa!
The terrorist organization has nodded off.
Good. Negative public finance. What did these guys want? Like the world here. Look at that. What is? Look at these numbers. These numbers are fantastic. We're coming up on $15 billion. $293 billion debt. Serbian eliminate host state. They keep wanting killing people. I'm not gonna do it. All right. So that's gonna be the end of this episode right here. Economic results. Inflation. I think went up. Unemployment's at 4% and growth is at 10%. The economy is really growing. Okay. Thanks for watching, everyone. Feel free to comment down below. Appreciate all your support, as always. Please like and subscribe if you did and you want to see more. And share it with your friends. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.